It's a complicated project, but a simple life. You can study whales all over the world, you can study harbor seals all over the world, but you cannot study them in silence all over the world. So we really need this sort of piece of wilderness, this untrammeled wilderness, as they say, in order to answer some of these questions.
So we've been monitoring underwater sound here in Glacier Bay since May of 2000. And the reason why we're doing that is to understand what the park is like from the perspective of a marine mammal, because marine mammals are very dependent on the natural sound environment.
If you sort of bring it back to humans, humans respond to noise in very stereotypical ways, and other mammals do the same thing. So, you know, if you go to a concert with your buddy and the music's really loud, you're going to talk at a higher pitch. You're going to talk louder, and you might have to repeat yourself. And marine mammals do the same thing if it gets noisy. So we're seeing, you know, just which of those three that they actually do. We're here on Strawberry Island for the entire summer.
We sample 8 to 12 hours a day. There'll be two people who are on our beach station doing scans, marking each whale in the area. Two people who are doing focal follows from our tower, which is a temporary tower that we have set up here on Strawberry Island. And then we have two people who are in the kayak who are doing fine scale acoustic sampling for harbor seals.
Got a harbor seal at 23 meters.
Got it. What's her bearing?
Bearing is 5822121.
Being able to pair what an animal is saying with where the animal is saying it is an amazing data set. It's a hard data set to get. It takes a lot of work, but it can answer so many questions.
So our cruise ship right here in the background is right on time today. We have a blissful hour and a half before the cruise ship gets here where we can watch our whales in silence. And then our ship comes in, bringing with it the noise that it brings, and we watch our whales while the ship's here to see whether or not their behavior is changing. And then it's going to go up bay and bring passengers to go see the glaciers, and we are going to get that blissful quiet again to see whether or not our whales are going back to that natural behavior.
This is the computer that runs our underwater acoustic monitoring, and there's a 5-mile cable from my office that leads out to a hydrophone that's out recording live sounds in Glacier Bay. And if I turn this up a little bit louder for the moment, that's the sound of a male harbor seal roaring because it's the mating season.
Strawberry Island.
Building a good field team and building some good camaraderie is really important. We have sort of these daily routines of things that we do together. So there's a schedule that we check every morning, who's gonna cook lunch that day, who's gonna cook dinner. And then every day we take a group photo. And then every day we do a daily check-in. We talk about what worked that day, what didn't work that day, and what we learned either from the island or from each other over the course of the day.
Surface 90060.
Last night, there were anywhere from 8 to 10 individuals right along the kelp bed off the point. We were trying to figure out exactly what they were doing. So as acousticians, Michelle and I got a hydrophone.
That seemed like the right thing to do.
Put the hydrophone in the water to see what was going on. Well, we dropped the hydrophone and it was so quiet. There was not a single roar.
Nothing. We heard nothing.
It was so unusual.
One of the things we did observe yesterday was two large bull killer whales who had come into the area that we learned today were transient killer whales. They do come into this area to hunt harbor seals. This is a pupping ground. That's what they come in for.
Yep.
We cannot in any way, shape, or form definitively link the presence of mammal-eating killer whales with the silence of harbor seals.
No, but it is quite interesting that they happened at the exact same time. It's always an adventure on Strawberry Island. You never know what the day's gonna bring.
This morning at 5:15 in the morning, the area was just boiling with whales. I had one 15-minute scan this morning where I was literally hopping back and forth on either side of the theodolite, calling out numbers to try and get all the whales as quickly as possible. And then 15 minutes later, we couldn't find them. aside from getting to be outside all the time, my favorite part of doing my PhD is getting to work with Leanna.
It goes both ways.
It helps when you put two minds that think differently onto the same problem.
Global ocean noise is a real problem. And there are areas of the ocean that have underwater sound from vessels so often that you could almost consider it an urban environment. Glacier Bay is a very remote area, and it was set aside as a national park in part to do scientific research. And we're privileged to be able to use it as a natural laboratory where we can better understand the impacts of underwater noise.
There are some places that act like characters in your life, and I think that a lot of Alaskans can resonate with the fact that living here is like having another family member. It's like having somebody really, really important who's sort of nudging you to be a little uncomfortable all the time and to stretch yourself all the time because it's worth it. I've lived here for almost 10 years. I've made Alaska my home, and so I'm an Alaskan by choice.